name is Sidefill, Philip Robinson. I've been mixing Kenny's monitors for about 18 years.
I'm Chris Raybould, I'm the front of house engineer here for Kenny Chesney on the Trip Around the Sun tour.
SE Electronics was pretty much an unknown name beginning of rehearsals. Our front of house engineer, Chris Raybould, contacted me and said he'd like to try it. He'd use it on some tours and had some other guys that he trusts use on tours that have kind of some of the similar problems that we've had with microphone technique and with sound quality and such in diverse environments and throughout. So reluctantly, I looked it up, and the price point on the microphone was so achievable that I was very worried that it wasn't going to do its job. But we tried it, and it was mind-boggling how much better it was than everything else we've tried.
Well, I knew of SE, I just knew who they were. Of course, I'd use a reflection filter. And then they came out with the MC1, and I had some friends of mine, Alex McLeod and Ken Van Druten Pooch, were out on Justin Bieber. They were kind of messing around with them. Andy Meyer got into it. He's got it out on Timberlake. It just kind of came down the pipe that, hey, this is something you should check out. And so I was looking forward to doing it and got the opportunity to put it on Kenny here, and we've been rolling with it since.
One of the simplest things about the MC1 that's even in the literature, it was thought about the shape of it. It's got an octagon head on it, on the grill itself, so it doesn't roll off counters. I know that's silly, but when you're working with 100 different microphones and all kinds of things on stage, it's nice to have something you can set down and it stays there. The fact that it's very reliable, we've had the same capsule on his vocal mic for the whole tour, and we're coming up on the end pretty quick here, within 3 or 4 shows, and we haven't changed it. It's the same sound that we started with in rehearsals, and it's the reliability, the price point, the fact that it works every day, the fact that it'll take a beating down the road and still do extremely well is just stunning. It was such a benefit that the opening acts, Old Dominion and Thomas Rhett, are using it also.
The aha moment, well, there was a couple. First of all, we put it up in rehearsals and it just performed well. Right out of the box, we didn't have to do a lot to it, it worked. The bleed, it's crazy how it works. The bleed is, it's not completely negligible to where it's some super tight thing and there's just nothing but this tiny little sweet spot. The bleed was still there, but it seemed to be fairly neutral what was there, and we just had good days with it. And as time went on, we continued to have good days, and Kenny was happy. The artist was happy right off the bat. The real aha moment, though, was when we got in front of PA, which, you know, rehearsal is one thing, where we are today in these stadiums is another. And I mean, from the jump, I haven't had, knock on wood, we have 4 shows left in this tour, not one instance of feedback the entire time. Kenny cups the mic, keeps it far away from his face, and yet it's always stayed constant, stays stable, and it hasn't wavered a bit, and our feelings on it haven't changed at all. It just works.